Copyright 2006, Seppo Pusa. http://www.naturalacnesolution.com. Even though the material in this book is copyrighted, you are nevertheless permitted, and encouraged, to download it, print it and share it with as many people as you like. However, if you do share this book with other people, you have to do it free of charge and must share the book entirely. Send your friend to this link where they can download their own copy, http://www.naturalacnesolution.com/book.htm. Send this file to a friend, it's quite big, so ask first. Don't know what to do next? Don't know how to detox? Want more information on diet and food? Have questions about fasting? How to make sure your detox suits your lifestyle, not the other way around? Register to my free support program to get answers, tips and hints. In fact, I'm sending some of my best material exclusively to my support program participants. To make sure you don't miss it, register at http://www.naturalacnesolution.com/support/sign.htm. Introduction. Does this sound familiar? I was sitting on a coffee shop with this one cure girl that I had met few days back. We were on our first date. When we had met at a club, things were going fine, we were laughing, flirting and generally having a blast. She was cute, smart, funny, etc. I was thinking that there could be something here. As we were sitting in that coffee shop, things were not so good. Every time I tried to relax and have fun, the ugly, red pimple on my left cheek felt like a giant beacon shouting, "Look at me, I'm here." I was thinking that did I hide it well enough? Oh, I hope she doesn't see it, she's gonna run away so quickly if she sees it. My leg kept bumping up and down. It was like it has a life of itself. I had to really focus and force it to be still. While I was calming my leg, my fingers kept fidgeting with the coffee cup. Every time I focused on something, I had to let some other part go free. If you have ever tried to stop a shaky house of cards from falling apart, you know what it was like. The funny and confident guy she had met few days earlier was replaced by this nervous, self-conscious, fidgeting HMMM nerd who had never had a date before. Needless to say, that thing didn't turn out to be the most fantastic romance in my life. She excused herself pretty quickly, and I never heard from her again. End of that sad story. Boo-ha me, let me level with you. Acne can be a very frustrating thing to have in your life. It's like a constant roller coaster ride of emotions. You hear about some new acne cure and get your hopes up. Can't wait to get your hands on it and try it out. The next morning you rush to the bathroom and check yourself from the mirror. 6. The pimples are definitely getting smaller. It's working. After a few weeks or a month, your morning wake up is not so gentle. The red spots on your face are a cruel indicator that your battle against acne is far from over. Things are getting back to normal. How many times have you repeated that pattern? How many different acne products you have used? How many bottles of lotion you have applied on your face? How many pills have you popped? How many times have you tried the miracle drug Accutane? Can you see a pattern repeating over and over again? You are definitely not alone in your struggle. Acne-related message boards and forums are full of people desperately looking for information on how to cure their acne. You can see the roller coaster ride there also. Somebody says that they have found something that works and others immediately jump to it. Little bit later you start seeing posts saying that the cure didn't work for someone or that its effect is fading away. If you are going through this, I really don't envy you. It's a sad situation to be in. Things don't have to be that way. You do have a choice. You can put an end to it now, once and for all. You can choose to keep on doing what you have been doing and getting what you have always been getting. Or you can choose to take on open-minded attitude and accept that things are not working. You can choose to accept that you have to do something differently. You can choose to accept that perhaps there is something that you don't know about acne and listen to people who actually have cured their acne. Often we are so blinded by our current ways of thinking that we become completely blind to different ideas. Sometimes our egos get into our way. We tend to think that we know everything there is to know about something, we know how it should be done. 7. Can you honestly say that your beliefs and knowledge of acne, what's the cause of it and how to treat it are not getting in your way? Can you honestly say that your beliefs about acne are serving you? For an honest answer, you only have to look at the results you are getting. Here's a quote from Benjamin Franklin: "The definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over and expecting different results." Like I said, you do have a choice. This book is not really about a single method for curing acne. In this book, I'm trying to tell you what my beliefs are about acne, what's the cause of it, and how it can be cured. I'm not saying that my version is the ultimate truth, but it works for me. Other people with similar beliefs have also gotten fantastic results. After reading this book, you should have a good idea of what causes acne and what you can do to cure it and keep it away. My ultimate goal for this book is to free you from frustration and desperation. So that you no longer feel that acne is some huge monster that you can't do anything about. So that you know exactly what you can do to get rid of acne, and you know what you can do to keep acne away. Even though I'm recommending some methods you can use to cure acne and I'm telling you what I'm doing, this book is not about a single one-size-fits-all method for curing acne. Ultimately, I would like to give you enough understanding that you know which methods and treatments work for you and which ones are just waste of time and money. Like the old saying goes, give a man a fish, feed him for a day, teach a man to fish, and you have fed him for a lifetime. 8. What causes acne? I think that the prevalence of acne is largely due to misunderstanding of the real cause of acne. It is really unfortunate that the mainstream dermatologist and medical community has become obsessed with eliminating bacteria, reducing sebum production and keeping your skin pores open. Please don't get me wrong, I don't claim to know the exact cause of acne. I believe that the exact mechanism varies from person to person. However, through research and personal experience, I have realized that certain conditions in your body make it more susceptible to acne. Whether I'm 100% correct with this, I don't know. But using treatments that address these conditions in my body has cured my acne amazingly fast. It has also worked for other people using this or similar treatments. Help your friends. Here's what you can do to help your friends that are suffering from acne. Send your friend to this link where they can download their own copy. Send this file to a friend, it's quite big. So ask first. Do you know someone who might benefit from this book? Please share this with them. Going through this program together with a friend can make a big difference to your success. That way you always have someone to help and motivate you when the going gets tough. You also get positive reinforcement when you watch each other getting clear. 9. Gut flora. So what exactly is happening inside your body that is causing acne? For that we have to explore what's happening in your gastrointestinal, GI, tract, that is food digestion mechanism. At any given point your body contains about 10 times more bacteria than you have cells. Now this is completely normal. You live in symbiosis with those bacteria and they perform many vital functions in your body. In fact, you wouldn't be able to survive without bacteria in your body. We can crudely divide these bacteria into two categories: oprobiotic or beneficial bacteria, that is the good guys. Opathological or harmful bacteria, that is the bad guys. Healthy human GI tract contains around 85% beneficial and 15% pathological bacteria. This is when things are working fine and you are healthy and vibrant. Still with me? Digestion and acne. Okay, let's set bacteria aside for a while and take a look at how food is digested. Digestion is unbelievably complicated process, and I doubt that anybody understands it perfectly. However, there are few simple basic truths that help us. First of all, complete digestion requires the help of multiple enzymes. Some of these enzymes are manufactured in your body, some we have to get from the food we eat. Secondly, these enzymes are very delicate and are completely destroyed by processing and/or cooking. Thirdly, these enzymes are activated only under certain conditions. In most cases, they require certain pH value. 10. Finally, your body cannot use food that is not completely digested. Partially digested food passed through your GI tract, but it can't be utilized by your body. Undigested food passes through your stomach and small intestine to your colon. Your colon is like a waste management station. Whatever food has not been digested in your stomach and small intestine is handled in your colon. Your colon absorbs what nutrients it can from food passing through. Rest gets dehydrated, compressed to feces and expelled through rectum. Now your colon walls are lined with protective mucus that prevents harmful bacteria and toxins in your colon from entering your bloodstream. In healthy colon, this mucus is mainly colonized by beneficial bacteria, but it also contains harmful bacteria. Undigested food creates an imbalance in gut flora. Harmful bacteria feast on undigested food in your colon. Undigested food putrefies and ferments in your colon. This putrefaction creates many toxins as byproduct. It's much like what happens in the garbage bin in your kitchen. Leftover food and trash starts to rot, and before you know it, stinks like hell. The only difference is that your colon has much more bacteria than your garbage bin has. Your colon is also warm and humid, which makes it an ideal environment for bacteria to thrive. If this would happen only once in a while, the beneficial bacteria in your colon would be able to keep the harmful bacteria at bay and repair the damage toxins have caused. However, if this onslaught is an everyday event continuing week, months and even years, it has dangerous consequences. With abundant food and fertile environment, harmful bacteria in your gut multiplies in number and gain larger and larger foothold in your colon. 11. Toxins leak out from colon. The toxic byproducts of putrefaction and fermentation of undigested food create an environment that is lethal to beneficial bacteria. Toxins also destroy the protective mucus your colon walls are lined with. As more and more undigested food enters your colon, some of it gets stuck to the mucus on your colon walls. Little by little, the diameter of your colon is reduced and it takes longer for food and feces to pass through. This gives more time for harmful bacteria to create havoc. Underneath the protective mucus, your colon walls are lined with blood and lymphatic vessels. In healthy colon, these vessels pick up nutrients that are passed through by beneficial bacteria. Toxins, harmful bacteria and parasites in your colon damage the protective layer of mucus. Before long, they destroy this protective wall, exposing the blood and lymph vessels underneath it. Now you have what is called the leaky gut syndrome. Pathological bacteria and toxins can enter your body through the exposed blood and lymph vessels. Your body has to protect itself. Blood and lymph carries these toxins to your liver and kidneys to neutralize. Unfortunately, your liver and kidneys can only handle so many toxins. If this toxic cycle is allowed to continue, their capacity will be reached. Your body does everything it can to protect itself from these toxins. If your body would allow these toxins to roam freely, they would cause serious damage to your organs and eventually kill you. Since your body's primary elimination mechanisms, liver and kidneys, are fully utilized, it has to turn to secondary elimination mechanism, skin and lungs. Now all those toxins that your liver and kidneys can't neutralize are pushed through your skin and lungs. Your body also stores these toxins into your fat cells, joints, muscles and bones. By capturing the toxins into these cells, your body ensures that those toxins can't harm you. 12. Good analogy would be nuclear waste. We bury nuclear waste deep into mountains until we figure out a better way to deal with it. Burying nuclear waste deep into mountains ensures that it can't harm us, but it does nothing to neutralize that nuclear waste. Meanwhile, toxins that are roaming free in your blood and lymph streams are disrupting functioning of vital organs. Toxins and acne. These are few possibilities of how this toxic condition in your body results to acne. One explanation is, the toxins that are pushed through your skin, create a fertile environment for acne-causing bacteria to settle in. Another explanation is that toxins disrupt hormone production. Many people claim that acne is due to overproduction of certain hormones that causes your body to produce more sebum and shed skin cells. The exact mechanism is unknown and probably varies from person to person. However, it all stems from the same basic cause, toxic colon that leaks poisons into your body. These toxins have a tendency of attacking the weakest link in your body. As that varies from person to person, it explains why some people get acne and others don't under same conditions. Instead of acne, other people get different symptoms, weight gain, yeast infections, bad breath, frequent headaches, infections, rash, allergies, chronic fatigue, etc. The main reason why I believe that toxins in your body are the root cause of acne is that treatments that address this condition work amazingly fast. Under proper detoxification treatment, you can literally get rid of pimples in 3 to 5 days. Compare that to the miracle drug Accutane, which takes months to work and is not even nearly so effective. These treatments also work on all types of acne. Another reason is that should you continue with the diet and lifestyle which caused this toxic condition, your acne will come back. 13. Recap. Let's recap a bit. So far we discovered the following: simplified, chain, indigestion, growth of unfriendly bacteria in your digestive tract, increase in toxicity that overloads your liver and kidneys, acne. Now let's take a brief look on the causes of indigestion. Don't know what to do next? Don't know how to detox? Want more information on diet and food? Have questions about fasting? How to make sure your detox suits your lifestyle, not the other way around? Register to my free support program to get answers, tips and hints. In fact, I'm sending some of my best material exclusively to my support program participants. To make sure you don't miss it, register at http://www.naturalacnesolution.com/support/sign.htm. What causes indigestion? Basically, indigestion boils down to the following: O, improperly combined food; O, lack of digestive enzymes; O, slow digestion; unfriendly bacteria have more time to ferment food and cause indigestion. I'm sure that there are also other reasons for indigestion, but those that the ones I'm aware. They also are the ones you have the most control over. 14. Food combining. Food combining seems to be another controversial topic. There are so many people with convincing arguments on both sides of the fence that one is bound to be confused. Over time, I have been on both camps. Sometimes believing in food combining and at other times not giving a damn about it. After doing quite a bit of research on how digestion works, I think that I have come to a conclusion that makes sense. I can also confirm these things with personal experience. First, let's take a brief look what the food combining advocates say. Their basic principle is that certain foods, mainly proteins, require acidic medium to digest, while others, mainly carbohydrates, require an alkaline medium. Acids and alkaline neutralize each other, thus impairing the digestion of both. Logically thinking, this thing makes sense, but then one has to understand that stomach is always an acidic medium, regardless of what you put in there. Small intestine should always be slightly alkaline for optimal digestion. Any food that's leaving from stomach will be acidic, and pancreas secretes enzymes that neutralize those acids before they enter small intestine. I do think that there is some truth in what food combining advocates say, but it's probably not quite simple what tell you. Let's examine what happens in your stomach during digestion. Stomach doesn't have such a large role to play in digestion that many people think. Acids in your stomach begin the digestion of proteins and they also kill bacteria in present food. Stomach also regulates the amount of food that's being passed to your small intestine. Stomach has very little to do with digestion of carbohydrates, but a lot to do with digestion of proteins. Pretty much the only role the stomach plays in digestion of carbohydrates is a temporary storage. What I mean with this is that carbohydrates sit in your stomach for about an hour, during which digestive enzymes digest them up to 75%. 15. After this, carbohydrates pass to small intestine for further digestion and absorption. Proteins sit in stomach for hours before they are ready to be passed to small intestine for further digestion. How carbohydrates and proteins interfere with each other's digestion. For protein digestion to work optimally, your stomach pH value must drop to 2, extremely acidic. Higher pH values can slow down or halt the digestion of proteins. However, the digestive enzymes that should pre-digest carbohydrates at the stomach are deactivated at such low pH levels. Thus, very little pre-digestion of carbohydrates takes place. Let's see what happens in your stomach when both carbohydrates and proteins enter at the same time. Once you eat protein, your stomach secretes hydrochloric acid to bring down the pH value so that protein digestion can begin. Presence of carbohydrates and sugars. Carbohydrates that have been converted to sugars by enzymes in your mouth. Both inhibit the secretion of hydrochloric acid and combine with the hydrochloric acid. There are two possibilities here, neither of which are good for you. Your stomach has to secrete more acid to bring down the pH value. More acids mean more work for your pancreas to neutralize these acids. This places extra stress on your pancreas to produce these enzymes. In case you have deficiency of minerals required to produce these enzymes, food entering your small intestine may be too acidic for optimal digestion. Alternatively, the pH value in your stomach remains higher than optimal. This means that protein digestion is slower and may not be complete. The higher the pH value in your stomach, the longer it takes for proteins to digest. Meanwhile, enzymes that should pre-digest carbohydrates are deactivated by low pH levels, and thus carbohydrates are not being pre-digested at all. The role of bacteria in your stomach. Despite being highly acidic terrain, your stomach does have bacteria. These bacteria ferment sugars and starches and putrefy proteins that are sitting in your stomach. 16. I haven't read any studies on this one, but if you put partially fermented or putrefied food into your small intestine, common sense says that it can't be good for digestion. Enzymes in your small intestine are not meant to work on partly fermented carbohydrates or putrefied proteins. Food combining can get complicated. If you read some books on food combining, you'll notice that it can get very complicated and that there are many rules. I haven't done any research on digestive implications of other rules besides the above mentioned carbs and proteins. From personal experience, I can say the following. Oh, don't eat carbohydrates and proteins together. Oh, fats don't agree with carbohydrates. Oh, fruits should be eaten alone. Oh, simples combinations always result in faster and smoother digestion for me. Oh, raw vegetables can be eaten with anything. Please note that those are not hard rules based on scientific studies. I have come to those conclusions by observing my own body after eating various food combinations. Fruits are very high in sugars and are digested very quickly. If you eat fruits together with foods that take longer to digest, the longer fruits will have to wait and the more time bacteria have to ferment them. Using this same analogy, any foods that digest quickly should not be eaten together with foods that take long time to digest. Try it out for yourself. As there are so many opinions and arguments on food combining, it's best to try it out yourself. Different people are likely to react differently to different combinations, so I would really encourage you to test and see which combinations are good for you. It's best to do these tests after detoxing. I have noticed that my body is far more sensitive to these things after fasting or detoxing. After detox, you are usually full of energy and it's easier to notice things that drain your energy or cause nausea and gas. 17. If you are interested, here are a couple of links to good articles about food combining. Take a look at them and see what makes sense to you. http://www.drucoslow.com/html/food_combining.html/http://www.drbus.com/sequential.html http://www.farmabus.com/article/dicknews.asp Article equals 112.97 and section it equals 46. http://www.medanth.org/case_studies/russia1.html http://www.thewolfclinic.com/pdf/food-combining.pdf Download a free food combining chart. Other reasons for indigestion. Not enough digestive enzymes and other micronutrients. Lack of digestive enzymes and other micronutrients, vitamins, minerals, etc., is probably another, along with improper food combinations, major cause of indigestion. Enzymes are required to start the chemical reactions that break food into smaller and smaller pieces. Enzymes also require vitamins, minerals and other micronutrients to function properly. Some of these can be manufactured in your body, but some has to come from your diet. Lack of these enzymes and other micronutrients slows down or halts the digestion process. This gives harmful bacteria time to putrefy the food. These enzymes and micronutrients are very perishable and are easily destroyed by processing. Cooking above 118 Fahrenheit destroys practically all the enzymes in food. Much of our soil is so depleted that farm crops depend entirely on the chemical fertilizers they are fed to grow. That means that the food we eat is totally devoid of virtually all trace minerals and micronutrients that we require for proper digestion and survival. I'm sure that you know that digestion begins in your mouth. Digestive enzymes are secreted while the food is in your mouth. To get enough digestive enzymes to the food, you should chew it properly, anywhere between 30 to 40 times. If you don't chew your food properly, it means that it leaves your mouth without sufficient amount of digestive enzymes. This slows 18. down the digestion process in your stomach and possibly also in the small intestine. Food takes too long to digest. To put it simply, the longer food stays in your digestive tract, the more time the ever-present harmful bacteria have to ferment it. Insufficient amount of digestive enzymes and other micronutrients is one reason digestion takes longer, but there can also be other reasons for it. Eating too much food at one time naturally places more stress on your digestion and ensures that you have food in your digestive tract longer. Diet low in fiber is another main reason for long transit times. Fiber is very bulk-forming and pushes food faster through the digestive tract. Stress can be another factor slowing down the digestion. One reason for this is that stress reduces the secretion of stomach acids required for digestion of proteins. It is very much possible that stress has an effect of secretion of digestive enzymes from pancreas. Stress also affects hormone production, and these extra hormones are deactivated in your liver and potentially reduce your liver's capacity to neutralize toxins and other chemicals. Don't know what to do next? Don't know how to detox? Want more information on diet and food? Have questions about fasting? How to make sure your detox suits your lifestyle, not the other way around? Register to my free support program to get answers, tips and hints. In fact, I'm sending some of my best material exclusively to my support program participants. To make sure you don't miss it, Register at http://www.naturalacnesolution.com/support/sign.htm. 19. Chemical and heavy metal poisoning. Let's briefly return to our cause of acne chain. Indigestion: growth of unfriendly bacteria in your digestive tract, increase in toxicity that overloads your liver and kidneys. Acne. So far we have explored the role of diet in this chain. While I strongly believe that diet is the main culprit for acne for most people, it is important to understand that there are also other sources of toxins/poisons that disrupt the normal functioning of your body and lead to acne. All chemicals that enter your body through food, drink, air, etc. are treated as poison by your body. They are taken to liver and kidneys for deactivation and elimination. This places additional stress on your liver and thus reduces its capacity to deactivate and eliminate other toxins. It is also possible that these pesticides and other chemical additives interfere with the chemical reactions during digestion process. Where do these chemicals/poisons come to your body? The following article by Mike Adams gives you some idea. Note: you absolutely should read the article before reading on this book. The Mass Poisoning of Humanity: An Exploration of Human Stupidity by Mike Adams. http://www.newstarget.com/00851111.html. Acid/alkaline balance and acne. Next, we need to briefly discuss acid/alkaline balance in your body. Acid/alkaline balance has lots of similarities to toxification of your body. Your body should be slightly alkaline, only digestive juices in your stomach should be acidic. Maintaining the correct balance. Keeping correct acid/alkaline balance is critical to proper functioning of your body. Thus, your body will do everything it can to maintain that balance. 20. In fact, you have alkaline buffers in your body that your body can utilize to neutralize acids. These buffers are certain minerals, calcium, sodium and potassium, for example. The largest storages of these minerals are in your bones. That's why chronically acid diet depletes these minerals and weakens your bones. It is important that we maintain a balanced body pH of ideally about 7.2 to 7.4, which is about neutral. However, because of our poor diet of junk food, fast food, overcooked, processed foods, especially soft drinks which have a pH of 2.7, most of us are not balanced. The above foods are several thousand times more acidic than our bodies. The pH scale is logarithmic, meaning that change of one unit, for example from 7 to 6, is equivalent to 10 times increase/decrease in acidity. This is important because harmful bacteria, parasites, etc. live and thrive in an acidic environment and do not live well in an alkaline environment. How diet affects the acid/alkaline balance. Now, certain foods tend to have acidifying reaction in your body, that is, they make your body more acid. You can see to detailed acid/alkaline food chart by clicking the links below. Please note that there are many variations of these charts floating around the internet. I don't know which one is the ultimate truth, so please consider any charts you find, including these, as guidelines rather than the hard truth. http://www.trends.com/1.mpicons/acidalka.html contains also good information about acid/alkaline balance and its effect on health. As far as I understand, there are two ways food can cause acidity in your body. During digestion, foods are broken down into smaller and smaller components that your body can utilize. This happens through chemical reactions that break molecules apart. Either the end or waste products of these chemical reactions are acidic. Acidifying foods may also interfere with digestion. Majority of the food you eat is digested in the small intestine. Your small intestine secretes enzymes into food, and those enzymes break food in two. 21. Molecules that your body can utilize. However, those enzymes require alkaline environment to function. Your stomach is highly acidic, and food that leaves your stomach is also acidic. Your pancreas secretes alkalizing enzymes into food that neutralize acids. Those alkalizing enzymes are manufactured in your pancreas from amino acids. Chronically acid diet, that is diet consisting mainly of meat, processed food, dairy products, sugar, rice, pasta, puts lots of pressure on pancreas to produce alkalizing enzymes, which means that your pancreas must use large quantities of alkalizing minerals. As a result of this, virtually every American has an enlarged pancreas by the time they are 40. Constant requirement of alkalizing enzymes from your pancreas slowly depletes your body's reserves of these alkalizing minerals. Over time, your pancreas may fail to produce alkalizing enzymes in required quantities. This means that food entering small intestine is still acidic. Digestive enzymes are not working optimally in this acidic environment. Undigested food passes to your colon, where harmful bacteria feast on them. Harmful bacteria putrefy undigested food, which results into highly acidic toxins. That is one of the reasons sugar is so bad for you. Harmful bacteria in your colon rapidly ferments sugar and produce acidic toxins as a result. You can safely generalize that toxins are always acidic, and that acidic reactions are generally harmful to your body. 22. Don't know what to do next? Don't know how to detox? Want more information on diet and food? Have questions about fasting? How to make sure your detox suits your lifestyle, not the other way around? Register to my free support program to get answers, tips and hints. In fact, I'm sending some of my best material exclusively to my support program participants. To make sure you don't miss it, register at http://www.naturalacnesolution.com/support/sign.htm. Curing acne. In the previous chapters, we have seen how acne develops and what the reasons behind it are. In this and the coming chapters, I'm going to show you how to break that cycle of disease that has caused acne and will continue to compromise your health. There are three steps you need to take. O. Cleanse your body from toxins. O. Alkalize your body. O. Replace the missing nutrients. Depending on the approach you choose to take, these steps may be separate or they may be achieved at the same time. On the other hand, fasting is an effective way to cleanse your body from toxins, but it does little to alkalize your body or to replace the missing nutrients. Whereas diet-based approach cleanses and alkalizes your body slowly by replacing lower quality nutrients with higher quality ones. Cleansing your body from toxins is really the step that is going to cure your acne. The last two steps are more preventive in nature. That is, they ensure that your body remains in good health, and thus ensure that acne will not come back. 23. Dr. Stanley Bass has written an excellent article on the symptoms you should expect when you detoxify. I highly recommend that you read it before starting any detox programs. What symptoms to expect when your body detoxifies, by Dr. Stanley Bass. http://www.drbass.com/symptoms.html. Different approaches to detoxing. I like to divide the different detoxing methods into two separate groups. O. Cleansing-based approaches. O. Diet-based approaches. Cleansing-based approaches include a separate cleaning stage, usually fasting or severely restricted diet. In diet-based approaches, you eliminate unhealthy items from your diet, thus reducing the stress on your body and allow it to slowly heal itself. People are often put off by the cleansing-based approaches because they fear that they can't go through them. Personally, I think that cleansing-based approaches are actually easier to go through than diet-based approaches. Why? Because it's much easier to bear a few days of discomfort hangover-like, than to fight your craving for weeks if not months. More on this little bit later, but fasting and other intense cleanses actually give you a clean break from food and substance cravings. Thus you are much more likely to stay healthy after a fast because the cravings are either eliminated or significantly reduced. Warning. While detoxing is completely safe for most of the people, there are some cases when you should proceed carefully. Pregnant or breastfeeding mothers should take care when detoxing, as the toxins from your body can enter the embryo or your breast milk. Also, if you have diabetes or other serious degenerative illness, like cancer, please consult your doctor before beginning your detox. You should also check with your doctor if you have been on medication for a long time. 24. Fasting. Everyone has a doctor in him or her, we just have to help it in its work. The natural healing force within each one of us is the greatest force in getting well. Our food should be our medicine. Our medicine should be our food. But to eat when you are sick, is to feed your sickness. Hippocrates, M.D. 460-377 BC. Father of Western medicine. Fasting is the best method for cleansing your body. Fasting means that you don't eat anything, or a very restricted diet, for a certain period of time, usually between 3 to 10 days. You are probably thinking that you are starving if you skip your lunch. How could you go for days without eating? Well, it's actually amazingly easy. Sure, it feels odd initially, but once you get onto it, you'll be fine. Actually, I have never felt hungry on any of my fasts. How fasting helps with acne. Fasting is beyond doubt the best way to naturally cure acne. Can you think of any acne treatment that could claim the following benefits? Oh, clears up all types of acne. Oh, you'll see first improvements within the first 2 to 3 days, and acne is usually completely eliminated within 5 days. Oh, works for everybody. Oh, doesn't dry your skin. In fact, it makes your skin smooth and radiant. Oh, eliminates the root cause of acne. Oh, automatically opens up pores and eliminates bacteria. Oh, normalizes sebum production. Oh, long-lasting benefits. Oh, 100% natural. Oh, no long-term side effects. As you know, there are no acne treatments that could come even close to that. If there were, imagine how much they could charge for it. People would pay anything for it. And it would be hailed as the miracle breakthrough in acne treatment. Well, it is truly a miracle, and the best thing is that it doesn't cost you anything. 25. In the previous chapters, we discussed what causes acne and how that condition develops in your body. Fasting completely reverses that process. Fasting triggers a truly wondrous cleansing process that reaches right down to each and every cell and tissue in the body. Within 24 hours of curtailing food intake, enzymes stop entering the stomach and travel instead into the intestines and into the bloodstream, where they circulate and gobble up all sorts of waste matter, including dead and damaged cells, unwelcome microbes, metabolic wastes, and pollutants. All the toxins that have been stored into your cells are dumped into bloodstream and eliminated. Suddenly, the harmful bacteria and parasites notice that their food supply has been cut off and the terrain that used to support them has become increasingly hostile. Fasting gives your vital organs time to rest and to be balanced. After removing toxins, acids and parasites, your liver can function at optimal levels. When you resume to your normal diet, your liver is stronger and healthier and it can better cope with the workload. How fasting helps you to keep acne away. Besides being the best natural acne treatment known to man, fasting also helps to prevent future acne outbreaks. Acne prevention is all about giving your body what it needs to be healthy. Fasting helps you to do this. Eliminates cravings. Do you often find yourself craving for unhealthy foods that you know are bad for your health and acne? Sometimes these cravings are almost impossible to resist. A proper fast eliminates most or all of these cravings by removing toxins, killing harmful bacteria and parasites, and restoring proper nutritional balance to your body. You can get a clean break of these cravings and are much more likely to succeed in maintaining your healthy habits and acne-free skin. resensitizes you to unhealthy food. Another way fasting prevents acne is that it sensitizes you to unhealthy food. Remember the first time you had a cup of coffee or smoke a cigarette? It tasted horrible and made you feel bad. After a 26. While you got used to it and you didn't get those reactions anymore. You may not be aware of it, but you have actually been desensitized to many other substances also. Fasting sensitizes you again to many of them. You'll notice that some of the food that had no effect on you drains your energy or makes you feel bad. This is very valuable information, because your body is telling you not to eat that thing. It's telling you that it's bad for you, and is likely to cause acne. Improves digestion. Fasting improves digestion by removing many digestion inhibitors. Improved digestion means that there is less undigested food for bad bacteria to putrefy. Of course, if you keep on eating the same food that caused acne in the first place, acne will come back. Gives a glimpse of what real health feels like. Perhaps the most important way fasting prevents acne is that you'll remember again what it means to really be healthy. How it feels to enthusiastically jump out of the bed in the morning. Perhaps for the first time you do realize that you can influence your health, and that you don't have to be sick and tired when you grow old. It is quite a difficult to explain to a normal Westerner what it really means to be healthy. It's like trying to explain color TV to someone who has been watching black and white TV for their whole life. You know it's so much better, but can't really explain why and how? This sounds really sad, but when it comes to health, most of us have been watching old black and white TV and the picture is steadily fading out. After you know what it means to be healthy, you definitely don't want to go back to normal. 27. Fasting may reverse the aging process and prolong your life. Consider the following. In addition to the human growth hormone that is released more frequently during a fast, an anti-aging hormone is also produced more efficiently. The only reliable way to extend the lifespan of a mammal is undernutrition without malnutrition. A study was performed on earthworms that demonstrated the extension of life due to fasting. The experiment was performed in the 1930s by isolating one worm and putting it on a cycle of fasting and feeding. The isolated worm outlasted its relatives by 19 generations, while still maintaining its youthful physiological traits. The worm was able to survive on its own tissue for months. Once the size of the worm began to decrease, the scientists would resume feeding it, at which point it showed great vigor and energy. The lifespan extension of these worms was the equivalent of keeping a man alive for 600 to 700 years. Source, http://serendip.brianmoore.edu/biology/b103/fo2/web1/coral.html#7. There have been similar studies conducted with mice. Those studies say that the mice who were periodically forced to fast lived up to 5 times longer than those who were allowed to eat all the time. I don't know of any studies conducted on humans, but regular fasters usually live easily more than 100 years and remain very active until their very last days. Fasting has also countless other benefits. Since this book is about how to cure acne, I'm not putting them all here. If you are interested, just search the internet for fasting or fasting benefits and you will learn all that you need to know. 28. Help your friends. Here's what you can do to help your friends that are suffering from acne. Send your friend to this link where they can download their own copy. Send this file to a friend, it's quite big, so ask first. Do you know someone who might benefit from this book? Please share this with them. Going through this program together with a friend can make a big difference to your success. That way you always have someone to help and motivate you when the going gets tough. You also get positive reinforcement when you watch each other getting clear. Colon cleanse. Earlier we discussed how unhealthy colon that leaks toxins into your blood is the root cause of acne. For you to get the most out of fasting, you should always do colon cleanse at the same time. I don't know for sure, but some authors have suggested that colon cleansing improves the effectiveness of fasting by 10 times. Now, I'm sure that that can be contested, but there is no doubt that colon cleansing helps enormously. After all, your colon walls are hardened with mucus. Click here if you want to know what it looks like. http://www.naturalacnesolution.com/colonpanzepix.htm that houses such unwanted guests as putrefying food, harmful bacteria and parasites. Mere fasting usually will not remove the mucus. It may kill the bacteria, but they will come back if you don't remove the mucus that houses and feeds them. Also, by keeping your colon clean, detoxification process is much faster and easier. If your colon is just leaking all the toxins that you worked hard to eliminate back to your body, you can be sure that you are putting yourself through unnecessary pain and trouble. 29. Clear colon will swiftly throw the toxins out. There are two approaches to colon cleansing: enemas and herbal laxatives. Enemas. Enema simply means that you flush your colon with water. As water flows in and out of your colon, it loosens the hardened mucus and takes it out. This procedure should be repeated once or twice a day for the duration of your fast/colon cleanse. You can go for a professional colonic, or you can administer it at home. Professionals usually charge around $60 to $70 per visit, so it can turn out to be quite expensive. Colon cleanse is completely safe to administer at home with Colema board. I'm using it regularly and can wholeheartedly recommend it. It's very simple to use and the results are almost miraculous. You can find more information about Colema board here: http://www.naturalacnesolution.com/products/colonclens.htm. An ideal companion to Colema board is the 7-day cleansing kit from Vitaratox. It contains everything you need to get the most out of your fast. I have used it personally, can guarantee its effectiveness. On the subject of enemas, you should avoid the various enema bags on the market. Since they are only using a small amount of water, few liters max, they are only good for clearing your rectum. Proper colon cleansing session uses around 5 gallons, up to 20 liters, of water and flushes your colon many times. Enema bags are simply useless for this purpose. There is no doubt that enemas are the fastest way to cleanse your colon and yield the best results. However, if you are uncomfortable with the idea or just want to start it slow, you can try herbal-based colon cleanses. 30. Don't know what to do next? Don't know how to detox? Want more information on diet and food? Have questions about fasting? How to make sure your detox suits your lifestyle, not the other way around? Register to my free support program to get answers, tips and hints. In fact, I'm sending some of my best material exclusively to my support program participants. To make sure you don't miss it, register at http://www.naturalacnesolution.com/support/sign.htm. Herbal-based colon cleanses. Herbal laxative-based cleanses use herbs that loosen the mucus and stimulate your colon to expel it. They are a very good introduction into colon cleansing. There are many colon cleansing kits in the market. I haven't tried them all, but looking at their marketing and ingredients, it seems that many of them are just riding the colon cleansing wave and offer little substance. You can find recommended colon cleansing products at http://www.naturalacnesolution.com/products/colonclens.htm. Cleansing supplements. While it is true that you don't really need anything to fast, your body has everything it needs. That said, there are few supplements that are highly recommended. They not only help your body in eliminating the toxins, and thus making the whole process faster, they also make it much more bearable for you. Psyllium husk. The first supplement you should use is psyllium husk. Psyllium husk is by far the most effective natural fiber bulking supplements for clearing clogged bowels of impacted feces, dry mucoid plaque and putrefactive food residues, which by the way we all carry inside us. When mixed with water and taken on an empty stomach forms a dense, mucilaginous bolus that sweeps like a broom throughout the entire digestive tract, loosening and eliminating. 31. Pockets of impacted putrefactive waste and mucoid sludge from the deep folds of colon. Psyllium husk dredges the colon of dangerous toxic residues that have festered there for years, and accelerates the entire detox process. Quote from the Tao of Detox by Daniel Reed. Bentonite clay. In addition to psyllium husk, you might want to also take bentonite clay. Bentonite clay is a very powerful detoxing helper. Bentonite clay molecules carry a strong negative charge and they stick to positively charged toxins in your body and carry them away from your body. Bentonite clay molecules are 200 times smaller than water molecules and can easily get into all the little nooks and corners of your body where water can't reach. It really makes the whole detoxing process faster. I had it on my 7-day liquid fast and it really eased the bad days of that fast. Highly recommended, and it's like less than $20, so it's really worth the small investment. Super greens. Third supplement to consider are so-called super greens or superfoods. Super greens consist of a blend of dry green vegetables that are full of vitamins, minerals, enzymes and other micronutrients. A scoop of super greens is equal to a pound of fresh vegetables. I recommend that you have super greens while on fast. Not only are they highly alkalizing but they are also full of micronutrients that your body can use while detoxing. Super greens can also give you that well-needed energy to go through the initial stages of the detox process. Probiotics. Another thing you might want to try is probiotics, especially during the last days and after the detox. Your colon needs an ample supply of good bacteria, probiotics, and during colon cleaning you flush out everything out from your colon. So it's important to make sure that the good guys get there before the bad guys can make a move again. Probiotics are also cheap, so give it a shot. 32. Enzymes. You might not think it at first, but enzymes can actually play a very vital role in detoxification. Let's first understand what enzymes are and what they do. For this I'm going to quote Dr. John Barron and what he said in one of his outstanding newsletters. Sidebar, I highly recommend that you subscribe to John's free newsletter at http://www.johnbarron.org. Back to enzymes. Enzymes are proteins that facilitate chemical reactions in living organisms. In fact, they are required for every single chemical action that takes place in your body. All of your tissues, muscles, bones, organs, and cells are run by enzymes, emphasis mine. Your digestive system, immune system, bloodstream, liver, kidneys, spleen, and pancreas, as well as your ability to see, think, feel, and breathe. In fact, the very functioning of each and every cell in your body, all depend on enzymes. All of the minerals and vitamins you eat and all of the hormones your body produces need enzymes in order to work properly. In fact, every single metabolic function in your body is governed by enzymes. Your stamina, your energy level, your ability to utilize vitamins and minerals, your immune system, all governed by enzymes. The vast majority of metabolic enzymes in the body, the enzymes that regulate everything from liver function to the immune system, are proteases, or proteolytic enzymes, enzymes that regulate protein function in the body. Now what does all this have to do with acne? For that let's divide enzymes into two groups based on how we use them, digestive and systematic. As the name indicates, digestive enzymes break nutrients into smaller molecules that your body can absorb. Without these enzymes, the digestive process would come to grinding halt and food would just putrefy inside your digestive tract. Your body can't utilize partially digested food. Taking digestive enzymes along with your food significantly improves digestion and prevents food from putrefying. Take off undigested food and you have taken a big step in preventing harmful bacteria from taking over your colon. 33. That would obviously be a major step in curing and preventing acne, but the good on enzymes doesn't stop there. The second group of enzymes is systematic enzymes, or, as some people call them, proteolytic enzymes. Systematic enzymes are not used for digestion, but they enter your bloodstream and are transported all over your body. Having these enzymes floating around your body has a huge number of health benefits, but I'm going to focus on those that have a direct implication on curing acne. Let's use a small metaphor to illustrate a point here. Just for a little while, imagine that your immune system is like a big gun that your body uses to fend off bad guys like bacteria, viruses, parasites, fungi, etc. But without ammunition, that gun would be pretty useless. Systematic, proteolytic enzymes are the ammunition for that gun. Bacteria, viruses, molds and fungi are protein/amino acid based, and are literally digested by systematic enzymes. Can you see how that might help with acne? Systematic enzymes can literally eat away acne-causing bacteria. Systematic enzymes can also clean your blood and lymph. Proteolytic enzymes are the primary tools the body uses to digest organic debris in the circulatory and lymph systems. What this means is that it takes some of the load off from your liver, giving your liver more time to clean toxins, chemicals and other poisons in your body. Other detox supplements. There are various other detox supplements that can be helpful. I consider the ones listed above as essentials, or at least very helpful. You can explore various other supplements here: http://www.naturalacnesolution.com/products/hhdetox.htm. 34. Diet-based detoxes. During a diet-based detox, you are still eating fairly normally, but you are eliminating many of the unhealthy substances and replacing them with healthier ones. This way you reduce the load on your digestive system and give your body more time to detox. You are also slowly replacing bad quality nutrients with higher quality ones. I have personally never used diet-based approaches for detoxing. For me, they are more like maintenance between fasts. I know that there are some good programs out there that will give you good results. If your goal is only to eliminate acne, then many of the diet-based approaches should also work for you. My only concern with them is that they don't activate the same natural healing process in your body that fasting activates. So I really don't know how deeply they will cleanse your body. Good thing about diet-based detoxes is that after you are done with them, it's easier for you to continue eating healthier, since you have already gone through the change process. Another thing I'm worried is that how many people can actually follow through such a diet? With all kinds of cravings urging you to eat what you used to eat, it may be difficult to go through them. That's why I feel that it's easier to bear a few days of discomfort at the beginning of a fast and be done with it. What should you do? I understand that natural health and healing are very personal topics and that you must do what feels good and comfortable for you. After reading and researching it intensively, I have found out that almost every expert has different opinion and routine to follow. I understand that this can make you confused about what's the best method to go on. I can only tell you to explore the available options and see what you feel comfortable with. I can also tell you what I'm doing. Though by no means am I saying that what I'm doing is the best way for you. It's something that I have tried and that it works for me. However, as time goes on, I will explore and try different things. 35. One of the reasons I'm a little hesitant of telling you what to do is that I'm not an expert on this subject, I have a certain amount of personal experience with it and I have read and studied it extensively. However, I still don't feel that I'm qualified to tell you what to do. That said, a second grade student can always teach a first grade student something. So I'll give you my 2 pennies and a basic understanding of the subject. I'll also point you to various resources that you can explore on your own and learn more. My recommendations. I'm a big fan of fasting and colon cleansing, and would recommend that you explore this option. For cleansing my colon, I'm using the Colema board that I mentioned at the fasting chapter. I have found that colonics, or enemas, really help the detoxing process. They also make a fast much easier to go through by taking out the toxins from your colon. It's amazing how much lighter you feel after a colonic. Also, just seeing what comes out of me is enough to convince me that I'm on the right track. I'm always cleansing my colon while I'm fasting. Whether it's a smaller 3-day apple fast or longer fast doesn't make a difference. I do it every time I fast. I have personally used the 7-day cleansing kit from Vitaratox. The kit contains supplements that help you to maximize the benefit of your fast and help you to go through it as easily as possible. The kit contains all the essential supplements that I mentioned earlier. The only addition to the Vitaratox kit I can think of are probiotics. The 7-day cleansing kit from Vitaratox is developed to be used together with Colema board. If you don't feel comfortable with the idea of daily colonics, you can also try the colon cleansing kit from Blessed Herbs. The colon cleansing kit contains similar supplements than the 7-day cleansing kit from Vitaratox, but instead of colonics, enemas, the colon cleansing kit uses herbal laxatives to expel mucus and toxins. Since toxic colon is the main culprit for acne, I would strongly recommend colon cleanse as part of your acne treatment program. 36. This is just my hunch, but if you don't take proper steps to cleanse your colon, you are neglecting a large part of the problem. If you don't remove the mucus that houses harmful bacteria, parasites and undigested food, what stops the toxins from leaking back into your body? After all, you are still carrying inside you undigested food and harmful bacteria that keep putrefying food and producing toxins in your bowels. There are many opinions about colon cleansing. I strongly recommend it, but also encourage you to do your own research and try it out to see if it works for you. Help your friends. Here's what you can do to help your friends that are suffering from acne. Send your friend to this link where they can download their own copy. Send this file to a friend, it's quite big, so ask first. Do you know someone who might benefit from this book? Please share this with them. Going through this program together with a friend can make a big difference to your success. That way you always have someone to help and motivate you when the going gets tough. You also get positive reinforcement when you watch each other getting clear. 37. Remaining acne free. There is really nothing mysterious about remaining acne free. To put it simply, you have to give your body what it needs and keep the stuff that it doesn't need away. Acne prevention basically boils down to 3 steps/items. O. Ensure proper digestion. O. Eat plenty of alkaline food. O. Maintain healthy colon flora. These 3 steps are by no means separate. Improving one of them also impacts positively the other ones, and vice versa. Diet for clear skin. In previous chapters, we established that your acne and health are closely related to what and how you eat. By now you should have an idea of the not so healthy food items that have contributed to your acne. Each of us has somewhat different requirements when it comes to diet and food matters, such as climate, level of physical activity, personal preferences and tastes, and your health goals all have an impact on your dietary requirements. This is not meant to be a complete day-to-day eating plan. Instead, I'll give you some basic guidelines on how to make healthy adjustments to your diet. Combine your meals properly. First and perhaps the most important thing is to combine your food properly. It doesn't matter how healthy your diet is if that food merely putrefies inside you. I really suggest making some research on the subject and see what works for you. At least avoid the biggest sinner, proteins and carbohydrates at the same meal. Not only your food digests better, but you also eat fewer calories. Cutting either protein or carbohydrates out and replacing it with a bowl of salad makes it so much easier to start eating more fresh vegetables. 38. It's really a double whammy benefit, and not so difficult to do as you might think. For the first week or so you might feel like there's something missing from your meal, but after that you'll get used to it. After a while you wouldn't go back because you feel so much better and actually feel more energized after a meal instead of tired and sleepy. Use fresh and organic ingredients. While you are having your salad, why not make sure that you use only fresh and organic vegetables? Chemically grown vegetables are usually full of pesticides and other nasty poisons that'll just build up inside you. Another thing is that organic vegetables are nutritiously far superior to chemically grown. As far as possible, use fresh fruits and vegetables. Frozen or canned vegetables have lost most of their micronutrients, enzymes, vitamins, etc., that are essential to digestion. Food that's alkalizing when it's fresh can turn acidifying after too much processing and preserving. You never really know how much preservatives they have added to the canned stuff. Not to mention that fresh vegetables always taste much better than frozen or canned veggies. Go raw. All the processing that is done to your food generally makes it harder to digest and more acidifying, with few exceptions, of course. Water and heat destroy most of the digestive enzymes and vitamins fruits and vegetables have. Without digestive enzymes, vegetables can do more harm than good to your body. Try to eat at least 50% of your food raw. This is where the bowl of salad instead of carbohydrates or protein comes handy. The digestive enzymes that raw vegetables contain help your body to digest the other food components you eat at the same meal. Raw vegetables are also highly alkalizing, so they balance any acidic foods you eat. This places far less stress on your body to leach minerals from your bones to neutralize the acids. If you don't want to go eat your vegetables 100% raw, you can slightly stir fry or steam them. I'm a huge fan of stir frying. Stir frying plenty of vegetables with noodles or some chicken, fish or nuts makes it so easy to replace either carbohydrates or protein with almost raw vegetables. 39. Another excellent way to have your greens is to make a green shake. My favorite one is mix of spinach, cucumber, apples and raw mangoes. It tastes very yummy. You can try with other combinations also. The basic idea is to use plenty of green vegetables and then some other ingredients to improve the taste. Green shake makes for an excellent breakfast also. When you have it on an empty stomach, you can really feel the energy surging through your body. It's an excellent way to start your day on a positive and energetic way. Here's what happened to me one day when I did it. http://www.naturalacnesolution.com/blog/2006/04/03/how-to-fight-acne-and-have-more-energy-than-the-energizer-bunny-in-less-than-10-minutes. html. Eat moderately. It takes a little time for the sense of hunger to cease after you have eaten enough. So one good rule to have is to stop eating when you feel 70% full. You'll quickly notice that by eating a little less you actually feel better and more energized. Eating too much food puts unnecessary stress on your digestive system. Larger quantities of food take longer to digest, giving more time for bacteria to putrefy it. Digestion is also a huge energy hog in your body. By eating a little less, you don't have to spend so much energy digesting that food, and you can avoid feeling tired after a meal. Respect your body's daily detox routines. While you are sleeping, your body is busy cleaning up the day's mess. Every night your body does regular repair and maintenance, including detoxification, work for vital organs. However, you have to give your body a change to do this. Eating heavy dinner late in the evening ensures that your body is busy digesting the food instead of resting and detoxifying your vital organs. You'll often notice this by waking up tired even though you may have slept adequately. It's best to avoid eating heavy food after 7 p.m. If you feel hungry later in the evening, opt for fresh fruits or vegetables that are easy to digest and give your body essential nutrient to help detoxification. 40. Same goes in the morning also. Try to delay breakfast as much as possible to give your body more time to detoxify. More healthy fats, less carbohydrates. This advice might fly on the face of what you have been told previously. In Western cultures, fats are treated like gremlins. You shouldn't go overboard with this one, but initially, when you are working to replace harmful bacteria with beneficial ones, try to lean towards healthy fast for energy instead of carbohydrates. There are two reasons for this. First, healthy fats are a much cleaner source of energy than carbohydrates are. The process of burning carbohydrates for energy in your cells produces acidic waste. Burning fats doesn't do this. Another reason is that all carbohydrates you eat are converted into sugars that the harmful bacteria will feast on. Fats are much more difficult for the harmful bacteria to use. Now you shouldn't just go and eat any fats. I'm talking about the healthy kind of fats here. Go for unsaturated fats from vegetable sources. Good sources include coconut, avocado, unrefined nuts, olive oil, flaxseed oil and most seed oils. Avoid saturated fats and hydrogenated, or trans, fats. I really don't know how big an influence this thing has, but if you are thinking whether to put coconut or pasta into your salad, go for the coconut. Foods that are skin sinners. Here's a small, not comprehensive, list of foods that most likely will aggravate your acne. So try to stay away from these. Excessive protein. Proteins are not only highly acidifying but they also take a long time to digest, ESP. Animal protein, thus giving bacteria plenty of time to putrefy them. Eat organic meat if you want to eat meat. That way you can at least avoid the hormones and antibiotics that come loaded with normal meat. Sugars and sweeteners. The harmful bacteria in your stomachs thrive on sugar, which they convert into toxic waste. It's not only the refined sugar that's bad for you, it's practically all sweeteners, including naturals like honey. Fruit juices are full of easily accessible sugar. I would even go so far as to advise you to avoid. 41. Fruits while you are fighting acne. After you have balanced the intestinal flora in your gut, you can include fruits into your diet. Replacing sugar with artificial sweeteners is even worse than sugar itself. Artificial sweeteners contain many chemicals that are toxic and convert to even more toxic chemicals, for example formaldehyde, in your gut. Click here for more info on aspartame and artificial sweeteners. http://curazone.com/foods/aspartame.asp. The only healthy sweetener I know is the herb called stevia. It's much sweeter than sugar and doesn't degrade your health like all the other sweeteners do. It's so sweet that you only have to use few drops of it, so it works out to be dirt cheap also. Dairy products. Cows, or any other animals, milk is not mean for humans. Dairy products slow down digestion of other food and give bacteria more time to putrefy them. Milk is also highly mucus-forming and coats your small intestine linings. This mucus inhibits absorption of nutrients through the walls of small intestine. Dairy cows are also constantly fed with hormones and antibiotics to maximize their milk production. Those hormones and antibiotics enter your body along with the milk you drink. Commercial yogurts tend to contain only small amounts of probiotic bacteria and are thus not a good source. It works out much cheaper and effective to take a good probiotic supplement. Tips for changing your diet. Now you should have a general idea what a healthy diet for acne-free skin looks like. Now you just have to change your diet, easy. Not quite. To smooth things out for you, here are two tips that have helped me a lot. Go easy. You are much more likely to succeed if you make gradual changes. I don't think I have ever succeeded in making a radical change. Because you will encounter difficulties, like cravings, during this change, and it's far easier to fight one or two cravings than a dozen at the same time. My principle is to drop one bad habit after every detox. It takes a little bit more time, but it's much easier to go through and results are almost miraculous. Regular mini fasts. Similarly, as you do regular maintenance for your car, you should do for your body also. It's a good idea to regularly give your body some time off. You can do this by doing 42. 1 3-day mini detox each month or detox 1 day each week. For example, you can choose to do 3-day apple fast for monthly maintenance. If you choose go with weekly maintenance, you could eat nothing but fresh fruits and vegetables for 1 day per week. These regular maintenance detoxes will make lifestyle changes much easier. You'll notice that cravings fade away faster, and you gain confidence from positive experiences. Super greens. I have noticed that taking super green, spirulina or other dense green food reduces food cravings significantly. Many of the food cravings are actually a result of nutritional deficiencies. A good quality super green supplement gives your body practically all the nutrients it requires. Don't know what to do next? Don't know how to detox? Want more information on diet and food? Have questions about fasting? How to make sure your detox suits your lifestyle, not the other way around? Register to my free support program to get answers, tips and hints. In fact, I'm sending some of my best material exclusively to my support program participants. To make sure you don't miss it, register at http://www.naturalacnesolution.com/support/sign.htm. Diet resources. http://www.foods.com/index.html. The world's healthiest foods. An excellent, free website full of resources helping you to eat healthier, includes tons of awesome recipes. http://www.honestfoodguide.org/free-downloadable-food-pyramid that actually benefits you, not the big business. Must have in your kitchen. 43. How healthy gut flora prevents acne. Let's take a brief look at the bacterial population in your gastrointestinal tract and see how it affects your acne and health in general. As I'm sure you are aware, there are both good, probiotic, and bad pathological, bacteria residing inside you. Most of them are found in your small intestine and colon, but they are also in other parts of your body, including your skin. Actually, the number of bacteria is 10 times higher than the number of cells in your body. Combined, they weigh up to 4 pounds. Those bacteria are not just parasites residing in you. You live in a complete symbiosis with them. As long as we provide them with a reasonable diet and as long as they remain in good health, these bacteria provide excellent service in return. It seems to be that in order for everything to work properly and you to remain in optimal health, at least 85% of the bacteria population should be good bacteria. I presume that you have acne, so it's very likely that the bad bacteria have taken over. Let's take a look at how these probiotic bacteria benefit you. They manufacture various vitamins. They manufacture milk digesting enzyme lactase. They produce antibacterial substances that kill or deactivate hostile, acne-causing bacteria. Some probiotic bacteria have shown to have powerful anti-carcinogenic features. They improve absorption of nutrients. They reduce high cholesterol levels. They neutralize many toxins in your body. They help to recycle estrogen, female hormone, which reduces the likelihood of menopausal symptoms and osteoporosis, so they protect you against food poisoning or improve your immune system. One could summarize that they fight against and counterbalance the effect of harmful bacteria has on your body. Earlier we looked at how overgrowth of harmful bacteria leads to acidity, acne and poor health in general. You could say that the most important function of probiotic bacteria is to keep harmful bacteria at bay. 44. Maintaining correct balance of good and bad bacteria in your gastrointestinal tract is probably the most effective way to fight acne. How you can then encourage growth of beneficial bacteria in your body? Well, not surprisingly, what's beneficial to human health in general is also beneficial to probiotic bacteria within you. We'll explore that in detail later. Supplements for acne-free living. Ideally, your diet should take care of all of those areas. But if you are anything like me, you like to eat food that's not so good for you. Because that's what you have always been doing and it tastes good. Nothing wrong with that. You just have to remember that everything you eat will have an impact on your body and on your health. Because the reality is that it has become nearly impossible to eat a perfect diet, I would recommend supplements to do damage control. Remember that your body operates in a certain way and it requires certain nutrients for optimal efficiency. If your food doesn't supply them, then you should try some supplements to help you out. It's practically impossible for me to recommend a supplement that would help each and everyone. Each of our bodies work differently, and what exactly causes acne for you may not do it for the next guy. If you read the chapters on what causes acne carefully, you should have a pretty clear picture on the support your body needs. Drawing from that, there are three basic supplements that should do the trick for most of the people. Supergreens. If you are not eating large quantities of raw, green vegetables, it's likely that you are missing vital nutrients and that your body has to draw from its storages to get what it requires. Supergreens alkalize your body, supply you a large array of vital nutrients, give you an energy boost, promote the growth of probiotic bacteria in your gut. 45. And detox your body. All in one package. Can you really ask for more than that? Enzymes. Are you chewing your food 30 to 40 times before swallowing it? Are you eating mostly raw and fresh food? If you don't, then it's likely that you are missing digestive enzymes. In this case, you are placing extra stress on your liver and pancreas to produce these required enzymes, which means drawing minerals and nutrients from your bones to produce these enzymes. Or that your food is not digested completely and some of it will putrefy inside you and promote the growth of harmful bacteria and parasites. Good supply of digestive enzymes will go a long way to prevent this. There is also another benefit of taking digestive enzymes. When you force your body to divert the enzymes it would use to as systematic enzymes, you compromise your immune system, and give the acne-causing bacteria and parasites more room to breathe. As enzymes are one of the most important supplements, you ideally should take two kinds of enzyme supplements, digestive and systematic, proteolytic. Digestive enzymes right before meals and systematic enzymes between meals. It is possible to use digestive enzyme supplement also as systematic enzymes. But the formulations are somewhat different, so it's recommended to take both. Systematic enzyme formulation requires much more protease, protein digesting enzymes, than digestive formulation does. So taking digestive enzyme supplement as systematic doesn't give your immune system that much ammunition and also wastes the other enzymes that are primarily meant for digestion. Probiotics. Remember those bad bacteria in your gut that putrefy food and create trouble that leads to acne and eventually serious health problems? Final destination is cancer. Well, they can't survive if you have a healthy supply of probiotic bacteria in your gut. After you have detoxified your body, it's a good idea to take probiotic bacteria to get the good guys in before the bad guys can make their move. If you don't know what to look for, choosing a good supplement can be difficult. You can find information on what to look for on supplements and brand recommendations at http://www.naturalacnesolution.com/product/supplements.htm. 46. Supplements are not a substitute for healthy diet. Remember, supplements are not a substitute for a healthy diet and lifestyle. Unhealthy and nutritionally poor food will promote acne in you. Supplements are merely for damage control, or give you some vital nutrients that you would otherwise get from your diet. Supplements are not a get out of jail for free card for eating whatever you want and still not getting acne. However, they will give you some freedom to indulge once in a while and still have a clear skin and good health. There is a worrisome trend that some people and alternative health practitioners use supplements as drugs, a prescription type. What I mean with this is that instead of looking at the root cause of problem, which in many cases is unhealthy dietary or lifestyle choices, they merely take supplements to eliminate the symptoms. Granted, this is much healthier than taking prescription drugs or not taking supplements at all, but do you really want your health to come from a pill? Use supplements strategically to help you. Don't make you and your health dependent on them. Healthy diet and lifestyle makes you feel so much better and you end up saving a lot of money. Help your friends. Here's what you can do to help your friends that are suffering from acne. Send your friend to this link where they can download their own copy. Send this file to a friend, it's quite big, so ask first. Do you know someone who might benefit from this book? Please share this with them. Going through this program together with a friend can make a big difference to your success. That way you always have someone to help and motivate you when the going gets tough. You also get positive reinforcement when you watch each other getting clear. 47. The next steps. Well, now it has come time that, I hope, you take action to get you where you want to go. Remember that information itself is worthless. If it would have some real value, all the librarians would be millionaires, but it's the application of the information that is going to make all the difference. Just to recap, I'm summarizing here the most important points about curing acne and keeping it away. There are also tons of resources that you can explore and benefit from. Get rid of the toxins in your body. First and foremostly, you need to cleanse yourself, and you should start from your colon. Before you have unclogged your colon, any kind of detoxing or fasting will only have a limited effect. While I strongly believe colon cleansing will get rid of your acne, there are people who require further cleansing to completely get rid of their acne. If your liver and/or your other vital organs are very badly polluted, you might have to do special detoxes to cleanse them also. In the interest of your health and well-being, you should cleanse them anyway. Also, once you experience the increased energy, clarity of mind and other benefits of colon cleansing, it's likely that you'll want to continue with that path. You can find recommended colon cleanses and information about further cleanses here, http://www.naturalacnesolution.com/products/cleanses.htm. Keep acne away. Keeping acne away quite simply means maintaining healthy gut flora and acid/alkaline balance. As long as you look after your health, you don't need any acne creams or pills. And if you don't, well, those creams and pills do a lousy job anyways. Making healthy dietary choices is obviously the most important step. No amount of supplements can counter the unhealthy effects of a bad diet, and healthy diet doesn't really need any supplements. The diet and food combining chapters give you some guidelines to making healthy dietary choices. Below are some further resources for you to explore. 48. http://www.foods.com/index.html. The world's healthiest foods. http://www.honestfoodguide.org/. There are further resources on healthy eating here. Unfortunately, it is becoming increasingly difficult to get all the nutrients you require from diet alone. Modern farming methods have depleted the nutritional values of many fruits and vegetables, and it is practically impossible to avoid poisonous chemicals in food and water. Therefore, you might consider taking some supplements to give your body the nutrients your diet might be missing. These supplements are also vitally important in helping your body detox and maintain correct acid/alkaline balance. You should consider taking the following supplements: O Super Greens, O Dietary and Systematic Enzymes, O Probiotics, at least initially and periodically to make sure that the good guys stay on top. You can find recommendations here, http://www.naturalacnesolution.com/products/supplements.htm. I would recommend doing a more thorough cleanse, 7 to 10 days with colon cleansing, once or twice a year. In addition to that, you should consider doing mini detoxes, 3 days apple fast for example, in regular intervals between the main cleanses. You can do these mini detoxes as often as you like. They are a good way to boost your energy levels if you feel that life is getting on you. They are also an excellent way to maintain healthy skin without using any acne products. Educate yourself. I really can't emphasize enough the importance of getting good, unbiased information. Take a look at the resources mentioned below. Reading them will both educate you and inspire you to explore natural health and healing methods further. Oh, read the lesson from the Miracle Doctors. You can download it for free here. 49. http://www.johnbaron.org/ebook.html, or if you prefer real copy, you can buy it from Amazon or take a look at the How Health Works course by Scott Algren, http://www.naturalacnesolution.com/products/hhwcourse.htm. It's an excellent way to deepen your knowledge about your body and health. Oh, read the free ebooks at http://www.truthpublishing.com or check out the wonderful collection of Natural Health Secrets by Chede, http://www.naturalacnesolution.com/chede.htm. Especially check the Detox Bible and H&B Fasting Classics collection. Oh, recommended reading The PH Miracle by Dr. Robert Young, The Tao of Detox by Daniel Reed. Oh, free newsletter. I recommend subscribing to Dr. Merkler's brilliant newsletter full of health-related information and products at http://www.merkler.com. News Target brings you independent and entertaining news on natural health, medicine, nutrition and more. Highly recommended. Subscribe at http://www.newstarget.com/readerregistration.html. Other resources: http://www.curazone.com, probably the largest collection of natural health articles and information I have seen. They also have very active discussion forum. On the downside, it's quite confusing to navigate. http://www.fmiracleliving.com/the official website of Dr. Robert Yu, the author of The PH Miracle. Excellent articles and recipes for healthy cooking. http://www.detox.org. Plenty of information on detoxing, book reviews. http://www.fasting.ws, information about fasting. http://www.heelan.co.uk/remediesdetoxing.shtml, Heelan Clinic. Excellent information for those who are just getting their feet wet on detoxing. http://www.yesthrifak.net/detox.htm. Skeptical Woman's Experiences and Views About Detoxing. Recommended reading. http://www.cleanse.net/news-index.html Information on colon cleansing http://www.liverdoctor.com/contains excellent information about liver health and what we can do to help or hinder this powerful organ. 50. The above is the cheapest effective way to eliminate the root cause of acne. Of course, it will be more expensive than most of the topical treatments on the market, but you will also get much better results. Not only you eliminate the root cause of acne, but at the same time you improve your overall health, have more energy, feel more alive, get more done and prevent a host of other diseases. Of course you can also keep doing what you have been doing so far. Just remember the quote from Benjamin Franklin in the introduction. The definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over and expecting different results. By now you should know why all the acne treatment and cures in the market won't work for long term. If you still feel that poisoning your skin with chemicals is the right way to treat acne, at least avoid the expensive commercial products like Proactive, and check out the Clear Skin Routine at http://www.acne.org. Unfortunately, there are no free rides in this world. You will have to pay the piper for years of unhealthy eating and living. You can choose to pay the price of discipline now or pay the price of regret later. By now you should know what the price of regret for acne is. And if you continue down the same track, you are likely to also pay the price of regret for far more serious health concerns, not to mention the spiraling costs of health insurance, drugs, doctor's bills, wasted time when sick, and emotional and physical suffering. It's up to you, it really is. 51. Help your friends. Here's what you can do to help your friends that are suffering from acne. Send your friend to this link where they can download their own copy. Send this file to a friend, it's quite big, so ask first. Do you know someone who might benefit from this book? Please share this with them. Going through this program together with a friend can make a big difference to your success. That way you always have someone to help and motivate you when the going gets tough. You also get positive reinforcement when you watch each other getting clear. Share this book with your readers. If you have a related website, blog, mailing list, etc., I have a lucrative JV proposal for you. Please use the form at http://www.naturalacnesolution.com/contact.htm to email me for details. Don't know what to do next? Don't know how to detox? Want more information on diet and food? Have questions about fasting? How to make sure your detox suits your lifestyle, not the other way around? Register to my free support program to get answers, tips and hints. In fact, I'm sending some of my best material exclusively to my support program participants. To make sure you don't miss it, register at http://www.naturalacnesolution.com/support/sign.htm. Also, make sure you have the latest version of this book as I am constantly updating it. You can download the latest version at http://www.naturalacnesolution.com/book.htm.